is that social media is too easy to measure. In the book, we talk about 26 different success metrics that you might reasonably use to measure the effectiveness of your social media program. The problem is not availability of data. The problem is figuring out which data matters. Because however your organization chooses to deploy social media, to what strategic end, dictates which success metrics make sense for you. If your company is using social media to drive awareness, that's one set of success metrics. If your company is using social media to take awareness and turn it into sales or lead gen, that's a different set of success metrics. And if, like a lot of companies, you are using social for loyalty and retention to turn your existing customers into volunteer marketers, into advocates for your brand, that's a third set of success metrics. Okay? You have to figure out what makes sense for your strategic narrative. But we don't typically do that because we thirst for the shortcut. We want it easy. We want math served up on a platter. We want the magic number that everybody can use. And unfortunately, in social media, those numbers are out there. We call them Twitter followers and Facebook fans. We don't even have to run a report. All we gotta do is go to our page, and our scoreboard is right there in the lower left-hand corner. How nifty is that? But here's the thing, Facebook fans is the most overrated metric in the history of marketing. Doesn't mean a damn thing, okay? It's at best a postmodern version of your email subscription. At best. Let's think about what it takes physiologically to become a Facebook fan. Let's break it down. As far as I can tell, it takes one click of one finger to become a Facebook fan. That's not exactly a blood oath, okay? That is a pretty weak commitment. It actually takes way more of your customers to sign up for your email newsletter than it does to become a Facebook fan.
Does it not?